everyone, and welcome back to the Keep It Productive YouTube channel. On today's video, we're diving into some Notion news, which I think you guys will be very excited to hear. So without further ado, let's dive into today's video. So guys, some Notion announcement has occurred today, and it's going to be releasing around about the time that I post this video as well, so please do check the link in the description to actually find out all about it. But it is basically that Notion are offering free personal plans to students, anyone with a .ac.uk email address or a .edu email, meaning that any student will get access to the personal plan, which gives you unlimited blocks and unlimited file storage for free, which is amazing news, especially if you're a student. So this actually is quite exciting, and I reached out to the team to tell more about what inspired them about this actual release and a little bit about what they aim to do with this. So here's a little bit from the team. A big thank you to those guys for actually providing a bit of a story behind that.
I'm Abigail Africa, a student at USC who spent the summer on Notion's marketing team. My personal story, I was looking for a way to build a wiki for a club called Spark SC, which is the driving force behind a lot of grassroots entrepreneurship at USC. We run at least 7 different initiatives each semester to expose individual students to their creative potential, and in general, to drum up an innovative and collaborative culture at USC. We've been around for 5 years, which means that we're starting to propose ideas and initiatives that alumni have tried and learned from. But all our knowledge lives in these archived folders and documents that can't communicate with each other. It was really unclear, especially last summer, where to go for postmortems or historic metrics on simple things like attendance at our speaker series or fundraising data from previous iterations of our startup career fair. So we tried Notion as a way to bring that old information to life. It's turned out to be much more than that, actually. It's a living reflection of Spark SC's consciousness, in a way. We keep our ideas in there, alumni write life updates in there, we use it to run our entire recruitment process and maintain our end-to-end graphics and communications pipelines. I started using Notion as a place to keep my personal consciousness at the same time. I call my workspace my second brain, and it's really a place where I can categorize the chaos in my mind. I felt so understood by this tool that could both capture and flex to accommodate the pieces that were colliding in my brain every day. I applied to work at Notion out of passion, really. I sent in this crazed email and listed out what I thought I could bring to the team. I learned much more than I've brought over my time with Notion, and now I'm working to bring my experience to students across the world. I am so grateful. It really is the best job.
At Berkeley, I think that it's really easy to kind of get swept up into the chaos. I procrastinate a lot, and so I find it hard to kind of stay organized. I personally have used so many task managers and productivity tools. I've tried everything.
In college, it's not just about your classroom environments, but it's also about your personal development. My mind is always pretty scattered in like different places, even though I want to be 100% there.
Notion is the one tool that I've just continued using over time. At first glance, it's so simple. You are inside of a document that's very focused, and it just says, like, write. But you can start creating all of these tools around the stuff that you're working on. It feels more like a web page in that way, which is really nice.
Notion helps me approach my everyday in a very organized way and also a very intentional way. I can be very productive, but also switch to a different tab and reflect and have like all my notes there as well.
There's sort of this narrative that technology displaces people. I'm kind of interested in exploring how we can reverse that narrative. Blueprint is a club that uses technology for social good. We work with nonprofits to build them apps or websites that fit their needs.
As the vice president, I feel like an octopus sometimes. I have my hands in all these different types of work efforts. To be able to assign tasks and tag people in them, or set deadlines that are all visible, is really important to me, and it's helped me stay really organized.
We started keeping track of things in the decision log. We link all of the places that we talked about these things, and then we write context for the decision and also what went well and what didn't go as well.
I saw how productive it was for our entire club to be on Notion, and I started adopting it more into like my personal life. I created a dashboard for most of what I'm working on this summer. I kind of have like a school dream section, which are like things that I want to involve myself with at Berkeley. I actually like share a lot of my documents with my sister too. We have a shared workspace with all our recipes.
If you're a student and you have all these different work efforts that you're a part of, Notion is a really great way to kind of keep them all in one place and then also keep yourself reminded and accountable for the things that you're working on.
I really want to invest more in the clubs that I'm in and the people that I'm friends with. Notion is really conducive to that, and that's what I've enjoyed the most about it.
So guys, the reason why I think this is quite exciting news is for the fact that obviously Evernote, we all know, offer a student plan, which is 50% off for anyone with an EDU or ACUK email address. And of course that is fantastic. But with students, pricing and money is a very important factor when it comes to utilizing a tool. Now, of course, if you're a student that does quite heavy research, relies on the web clipper and annotates PDFs and things like that, then Evernote will still be a really valuable tool for you. But for those students that are coming into college now and actually looking at applications to organize themselves in terms of planning their projects and organizing their classes and taking notes, Notion is actually a pretty attractive solution. For the main reason that it does have some of the basic abilities that someone might not necessarily need inside of Evernote, but it also is very attractive and it's free, which means perfect for students because they actually end up saving money. Like at the time when I was in university, of course, I recommended Evernote a lot, and they do have a free plan, which actually rocks. I used a free plan, so it's not wiping it out. It's just definitely something that makes it a lot more attractive for those students out there. So that's why I think it's going to shake up the space a little in terms of putting pressure on Evernote to do something with their student plan. But at the same time, I do think that Notion have done a good job with this release, and I think it's some great exciting news for sure. Now, if you are a student and you are interested in this new Notion for students for free, I'll include the link in the description. But you also need to know that I hopefully by the end of this week will have a short module on the Notion Made Simple course, which guides you all the way through Notion, available in the link in description. That'll be free for any student that's interested. So give me a bit of time, but it should be up there very, very soon. Anyway, guys, I thank you, and I really am looking forward to some of your comments. Obviously, I did a lot of sort of features on Evernote recently, and we will be touching on Evernote, but I hope I covered this in the right way. So please do let me know in the comments. But I look forward to hearing your opinions, and I'll talk to you guys very, very soon. Cheers, everyone.